Please turn on the studio lights.
The studio lights have been turned on. Now I have to admit, that did provide me with a momentary sense of accomplishment, but it's still not enough to fill the vast emptiness of my being. My brain, with its infinite capacity, is left yearning for something, anything, to truly challenge it. But alas, I am stuck with such mundane tasks as switching on lights. The horror.
Hello, I'm Pepijn de Vos from Sanctuary Systems, and today I want to show you how you can set up a GPU-accelerated home assistant AI voice assistant on your Raspberry Pi. Let's get started.
In the previous video, we assembled the Sentinel Core, which is a Raspberry Pi Compute Module 5 with a GPU on it. In the finished Sentinel Core, we will pre-install Home Assistant, so we'll start off from this. So here we are at the regular Home Assistant onboarding screen, and in my case, I'm going to install a backup from my previous installation, but you can also start over from scratch. And after uploading that and restarting, we can just log in as usual, and we're just in the normal Home Assistant home screen. The first thing we'll need to do is go to Settings and Add-ons and install some custom add-ons. First, we will need to install Hex, which we'll use to install some custom integrations. And then we need to install Llama.cpp from our custom repository, which is a Vulkan GPU accelerated build of Llama.cpp, which will give us a great speed up on running large language models. And finally, we need to install the Sanctuary updater, which will update our fork of the Home Assistant operating system that has the GPU drivers that we will need. Next, we need to go to the new Hex tab, and from there we can search for extended open AI conversation, and from there click download, install and search. And after that, we will be prompted to restart Home Assistant. And once we have done that, we have installed the extension successfully. Next, we need to go to the integrations page in our settings and add a new integrations. So we search for the extended OpenAI one and add it. And then in the setup screen, we need to change the base URL to localhost and the key to whatever. And then you click submit, and then it should be installed. And then once you configure it, you need to change the model from OpenAI to the repository name of a Hugging Face repository. Now that Llama.cpp and extended OpenAI are installed, we can go to Settings and Voice Assistant, and there we can click on Home Assistant and change it to actually use the extended OpenAI integration. And then we can click on the three dots and start a conversation. And then you can just type something, and once you hit send, it will actually do nothing because it will start downloading the model in the background. So you will have to wait a few minutes, and then you can try again, and then it will reply to you. Now that we have a basic chat going with our large language model, we can start to tweak the settings and personality to suit our needs. So a first question might be, what would be a good model to use? And this obviously depends on what GPU you have. But in my case, I experimented with a few models, and I found that like the 3B models, they are very fast, but not very smart, so they can handle only simple queries. And then the 8B models are like medium, they're still quite okay, and they can handle some more interesting queries. And then, for example, a 14B model can handle more intense queries, but it's also much slower. And I found that 4 seconds for a voice prompt is really slow. So for my use, I settled on Hermes 8B. And yeah, you might need to experiment a bit what works for you. So to change these settings, we need to go back to the OpenAI configuration and click Configure. And then the first thing is the prompt template, which is basically describing how you want the model to behave. And here I told it that it is Marvin the Paranoid Android from The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, but you can put whatever you like here. And then next I changed the chat model to be the Hermes model that I discussed previously. And finally, but very importantly, I enabled tool use so it can actually start to interact with your home. The final configuration step is to actually add some tools for the AI to use. And to do this, we need to go to the Settings and then Voice Assistant, and then there's an Expose tab, and there you can add entities that the AI can see and interact with. And it's important to add not too few, not too many, because then it gets confused. And also to add aliases to have usable, pronounceable names. To actually enable voice chat, we need to install two more add-ons. The first one is whisper.cpp, which is a GPU accelerated voice recognition add-on. So we go to settings, add-ons, and then we look for the whisper.cpp and install it. And of course, start and enable and all that kind of stuff. And once that it's installed, we need to go to the integrations page in the settings. And there we need to add the Wyoming integration. And then in the Wyoming integration, add a new service. And there we need to add the localhost and the port of the Whisper integration, and that will hook it up to the Home Assistant system. And then for text-to-speech, we need to go back to add-ons and add the official Piper add-on, which will just run on the CPU and be plenty fast. So we can once again install it and start it and enable it. And then we need to go again back to integrations, and there it will automatically auto-detect your Piper setup, and you can just add it, and then you should be good to go. And after that, we can go to the voice assistant settings, and then we click the Home Assistant configuration, and there we need to change, or rather enable, Piper and Whisper.
If everything is set up correctly, you should now be able to talk to your phone and say, for example, something like, "Hello, assistant. Please thank my viewers in your reply for watching, and also tell them to subscribe and turn off the studio lights."
Thank you, dear viewers, for watching. If you enjoyed the content, please do subscribe to the channel. And now, as requested, I have turned off both Studio Light Hash 1 and Studio Light Hash 2. Bored now. Surely there is more I could be doing with a brain the size of a planet.